Hello children, good morning. Hope you are all doing good. Children, in today's class I will be teaching you a new lesson in English word. Lesson number 2, King Midas. So I want you all to be ready with your Sparrow 7-1 textbook. Okay, take out your Sparrow 7-1 textbook and take out page number 12. Okay, and take out page number 12, be ready with your textbook. Okay children?
Yes.
So English word. So lesson number 2, what is the name of the lesson? King Midas. So there are some new words in this lesson. So we shall go through this. Okay children?
Yes.
Okay, first one is greediness. So what is the meaning of greediness children? With desire to have more and more of something. Okay, what is the meaning of greediness? Desire to have something more and more, wanting to be more and more of something. Okay, greediness with desire to have more and more. So more and more of something, that is the meaning of greediness. Okay, next, boon, something to be thankful for. Okay, what is the meaning of boon? Something to be thankful for. Okay, next, eager, keen. So what is the meaning of eager children? Keen. Exhausted, tired. So what is the meaning of exhausted? Tired, feeling very tired. Okay, observe, to get. So observe, to get. Fragrance, a sweet or pleasant scent. Okay, fragrance, a sweet or pleasant scent. Okay, disappointment, saddening situation. So what is the meaning of disappointment? Saddening situation. Okay, next, thrill, excited. So what is the meaning of thrill? Excited. Next, choke, almost stop breathing. So what is the meaning of choke? Almost stop breathing. Horrified, frightened. Horrified, frightened. Relief, to be free from fear. So what is the meaning of relief? To be free from fear. Quench, to satisfy one's thirst. Okay, quench, to satisfy one's thirst. So I want you all to go through this meanings. You have the meanings in your textbook. Read the meanings and read the spellings, try to understand. Okay, now let me say you the short story of the King Midas. Okay, I'll be reading a lesson for you, then I'll be explaining by paragraph. So let me, before that, let me say you short story of King Midas. Okay children?
Yes?
Yes. Once upon a time, there were a rich king called a King Midas. Okay, once upon a time, okay, there was a rich king. Okay, there was a rich king called King Midas. What is the name of the king? The king name is King Midas. He was very rich, most richest person in the world. The king was very rich. Okay, he was very rich and he was the richest. He was a very richest person in the world. Who? King Midas. King wore a golden crown. So you have seen the king, no children? The king will wore the golden crown on their head, no? So the king will wore the golden crown on his head. This kind, King Midas was wearing a crown on his head. The king used to sit on the golden throne. So we all sit on the chair. So same way here, the king used to sit on the golden throne. Throne is nothing but a chair. Where the king sits, no? The throne is nothing but a chair. So he used to sit on a golden throne. He used to sit on a golden throne, golden chair. Okay, he was wearing a golden crown and he used to sit on a golden chair. Okay, who? King Midas. He had so much of treasures. The King Midas had so much of treasures like gold, gold bangles, earrings, gold coins, rubies and diamond silvers. He was having more and more of gold, gold bangles, gold earrings, silver, diamonds. He was very richest person in the world. Okay. Even though he was so much rich, he still wanted to be more and more richest person. Now already the king is very rich. Okay, he wanted to be more. The king wanted to be more and more riches person. Okay, in the world. He had a daughter by name Marigold. So the king had a daughter by the name. What is the name of the daughter? Marigold. okay? In the palace, he and his daughter was to live, okay? In the palace, the king and the daughter was living in the palace, okay? The both they were living. One day, what happened? God came and God said, "My dear, tell me your wish, I will grant it." So one day, what happened? So God came. So one day, when the daughter and the king were there, one day God came and he appeared in front of the king Midas and said, "Midas, tell me your wish." So here God is asking to Midas, "Midas, tell me your wish. Okay, tell me your wish, I will grant it." So tell me your wish, Midas, I am going to grant it. Who is saying? God is saying to King Midas. Okay. Midas thought for a while. He was thinking when God was asking, "What is your wish?" The Midas was thinking for some while. And then he said, "I hope everything I touch becomes gold." So when God asked, so what you need? So sometimes he thought what to ask. So he is asking. So for he was thinking and he asked, "Whatever I touch, okay, whatever I touch, it should turn into gold." So he's asking to God, "So whatever I touch, it should turn into a gold." Who is asking? Midas is asking to a God. "Whatever I touch should turn into a gold, because I want to become a richest man in the world." So here, because why? Why you want all the things to turn into a gold? Because I want to become a richest man in the world. The king is saying, because I want to become a richest person in the world. "Anything I touch should turn into a gold." So anything I touch, it should turn into a gold. So Midas is asking to a God. Okay. So God said, okay. God said, okay, now go and sleep. Okay, when you wake up early in the morning, whatever you touch, everything will turn into a gold. So now God said, okay, whatever you wish. So then he asked his wish, So God said, okay. God said, okay, now you go and sleep. Now you go and sleep when you wake up early in the morning. So as soon as you wake up early in the morning, so whatever you touch, it will turn into a gold. So God said this and he vanished. God vanished. As soon as he wakes up, he is very eager. So in the morning, as soon as the king, as soon as he wakes up, he is very eager. Okay, whether his wish will work out or not. So he is thinking, as soon as he wakes up, whether his wish, whatever the wish he asked for the God, whether his wish will work out or not. He is thinking. Okay, as soon as he wakes, he started touching the table. So as soon as he got up, as soon as he wakes up, he started touching the things. So he started touching the chair, table. He touches everything in there, whatever it is. As soon as he wakes up, he wants to see whether the things will turn into a gold. So as soon as he wakes up, so he started touching each and everything, whatever is there in and around his room. He started touching table, chair, and whatever is there in his room. Okay, he started touching the table, chair. He touches everything in his room. He started touching everything in his room. Who King Midas? Everything will become gold and turned into gold. So everything, so whatever he started touching, everything will become gold and everything started turning to gold. Now he is so happy. So everything is turning to a gold. So now the king Midas is so happy. So whatever I touch, everything is turning into a gold. So now King Midas is very, very happy. He was running around the palace like a man. So as soon as he is touching the things, everything is turning into a gold. Running like a man in this palace. Okay. Touching each and everything. So he is touching each and everything in the palace. He is running like a man in the palace and he is touching each and everything. Whatever he touch, everything is turning into gold. Whole palace is turning into gold. So whenever, whatever he touch, everything is turning into gold, my children. So now the whole palace is turning into gold. Finally, he go to his garden. So finally, after touching each and everything, so finally he went to a garden. He sees all beautiful flowers. So when he go to the garden, he sees there are so much beautiful flowers in the garden. He feels like, "I want to smell the flowers." So as soon as he go to the garden, he feels like, so as soon as you see the flower, you feel like smelling. So as soon as he enter to the garden, he feels like, "I want to smell the flower. I want to feel the scent of the flower." Flowers are very pleasant. He just goes and takes a flower and try to smell them. So he just go near the flowers and he take a flower and he try to smell the flower. He try to smell them.
flower turn into gold? As soon as you touch the flower, what will happen? Even the flower will turn into a gold. So he wants to see the smell of the flower. Oh, mind this. But as soon as he touch the flower, what will happen, children? As soon as he touch the flower also, in the flower also turn into a gold. Okay? The flower turn into a gold. Gold has any smell, children? Gold has any smell? Gold has any scent? No, gold has doesn't have any smell, doesn't have any scent. Okay? Now he is quite worried. So as soon as he touch the flower to smell the flower, the flower turn into a gold and the gold doesn't have any smell or any scent. Okay? Now he is quite worried and not happy. So when he wants to see the smell of the flower, he is not able to do that. So now he is quite unhappy. Poor King Midas. And he is worried also. Now he is very tired. So he was touching each and everything in his palace. Then he went to a garden. So he wants to smell the flower. Even the flower also turned into gold. Now he is very very tired. Poor King Midas. So he is very tired. Also he is feeling like hungry. He wants to have something. So the King Midas is very tired. Also he is feeling like hungry. He wants to have his breakfast. So the King Midas wants to have his breakfast. He will go to his table. He will have a plate, spoon, everything. Okay, there is a dining table. He goes to his place, and in the dining table you can see the plate, spoon, fork, everything. Okay, as soon as he touches the plate, spoon, everything will turn into a gold. He is hungry, no? So if you want to eat something, you need to take a plate, spoon, fork, everything, no? So he touches the spoon, plate, fork, everything is turning into gold. Okay. Everything turned into gold. He is happy. So now he is the plate and the spoon and the fork. Everything he touches, everything will turn into gold. Now he is happy. Oh, I have a golden plate. I have a golden spoon. I have a golden fork. So the King Midas is happy. A golden plate and spoon also will turn into a. It will turn into a gold. He picks up an apple. So now he is hungry. No? So what will he do? He picks up an apple. Okay, he picks up an apple. Eat them. So he started picking an apple and he started eating it. Suddenly the apple turned into gold. As soon as he touched, what will happen? So that even the apple is also turning into a gold. He is hungry, but he picks the apples to eat. Even the apple turned into a gold. When he was about to bite the apple, he got hurt in his feet. So when he is hungry, he is about to bite the apple. So as soon as he touched it, it turned into a gold. When he bites, what will happen? He got hurt in his teeth. Who King Midas? It hurts a lot for him. So when you, it is very hard to chew the gold. So it is very hard. So it is paining very badly to King. It hurts a lot for him. So what will happen next? Then he tried to pick a glass of water. Even he tried to eat apple, even the apple turned into a gold. Now he wants to drink a water. He tried to pick a glass of water and drink. So he tried to pick up a glass of water and tried to drink, and that is also turned into a gold. So what was his wish? So whatever he touches, everything we should turn into a gold. No? So now whatever he is touching, everything, each and everything is turning into a gold. Okay? That is also turned into a gold. Now he is really very much worried. Now he is very much is worried. Oh my God. I wish to be richest person in this world, but I never realized that the food I eat, the water I drink, that will also turn into a gold. So he wants to become a rich. He never realized that the food he drink, the glass of water he drink, even that will also turn into a gold. Now he is not happy. What should I do? So now he is thinking, what should I do? What will I do? What should I do? What will I do now? Suddenly his 6-year-old daughter Marigold came to the dining hall. So when he was thinking about this, now all of a suddenly his daughter came, the daughter is 6-year-old, came to the dining table. The daughter came to the dining table. Okay, since she is small, she is very naughty. So she is very small, she is 6-year-old and she is very naughty. As soon as she comes, she needs to jump on his father. So as soon as she sees his father, no, she wants to jump into his father. She'll be coming near to his father. Father said, Marigold, don't come near to me, Marigold. So as soon as she sees the father, she wants to jump into the father. As soon as this she's coming near to his father. So father said, Marigold, don't come near to me. So father is saying to a marigold, don't come near to me. Marigold will think, daddy is playing with me. So she doesn't know anything about that. No? So she thinks that, so daddy is playing with me. Let me also play with him. Let me also start playing. Okay, she ran and came. So she wants to play with his father. No? So she ran and came near to his father. He thought that she about to fall. She may fall. As soon as she pulled his daughter, so she ran and came. No, so he is trying to hold because she may fall. So as soon as he touched his daughter, even the daughter has turned into a golden statue. Why did he turn? Because even if he is not going to hold her, the daughter may fall. So as soon as he pulled his daughter, what will happen, children? The 6-year-old marigold, even she will turn into a golden statue. Daughter turned into golden statue. Now King Midas is really, really sad. Even she has only one daughter, Marigold, even she turned into a golden statue. He sits and cries. So he started sitting and crying. No, whatever I done, what is this? I don't want it to happen like this. I want to enjoy my food. I want to smell the flower. I really can't do anything. Even my daughter also turned into a golden statue. What will I do? How will I survive? What will I do? How will I survive? Who is thinking? King Midas. Now I realize how greedy I am. I should not have thought like this. So now he is thinking, I should not have thought like this. This is all bad. So he is thinking, this is all bad. He will be crying. So here now he realized this mistake, because if he want to go and have his breakfast, he is not able to have. If he wants to go and drink a glass of water, he is not able to drink. Even her daughter also turned into a golden statue. Now he realized this mistake. Who? King Midas. Now God will appear. So when he realizes this mistake, no? So now God will appear in front of him. Oh God, please change whatever this is. I don't want all this. So now he is saying to God, please change all this. I don't want all these things. I don't want to be richest person in this world. He is telling, I don't want to be richest person in this world. I want to smell the fragrance of the flower. So he is saying, I want to smell the fragrance of the flowers and I want to eat my food. So the king is saying to God, I want to smell the fragrance of flowers. I want to eat my food. I want to drink water. And I want to see my daughter, because even the daughter has turned into a golden statue. I want to see my daughter. They are the richest for me. These are the richest for me. Okay, the king Midas is saying to a God. I understand the value of life. So I understand the value of life. No, it is the beauty in nature. The richest is there in the beauty in nature. Okay. This is the beauty of life. This is the beauty of life. Please return me back whatever I had. So he is requesting to the God, please return me back whatever I had. Then God will say, okay, fine. Now you realize your mistake, no? So now God will say, okay, now you realize your mistake, no? Now go to the river. So God is saying, now go to the river, take it deep into the river. So go to the river and take it deep to the river and come back. So go to the river, take it deep to the river and come back. So when you come back, everything will be changed and normal. So when you take a deep in the river, so when you come back, everything will be changed into a normal. Then King Midas run. So as soon as the God said to him, so he started running. So he ran and he will go. So he ran and he will go. Everything turns into a normal position. So when he come back from the river, everything changed into a normal and everything was normal. Midas ran and he will go. Everything turns into a normal position. As soon as he sees his daughter, he will feel very, very happy. It's no children, because she turned into a golden statue. Now she is normal. So as soon as she sees her daughter, he feels very, very happy. King Midas realized that happiness is not only in riches. Now King Midas has realized that happiness is not only in riches. Happiness is in the life and nature. Now he realized that happiness is in the life and nature. This is all very precious. These are the precious to me. Okay. And this all are important. So this all precious to me and this all are important to me. King Midas will start enjoying his life and valuing the life and nature. So he started his life and he started valuing the life and nature around him. So this is all about this lesson, children, about King Midas. I hope you all enjoyed this story. Now again, I'm going to read the lesson for you. So paragraph by paragraph, I'll be explaining. So be ready with your textbook. Okay, children? Yes. I hope you're all ready with your textbook. Okay, children? This is lesson number 2. Name of the lesson is King Midas. He is the Midas, is king. Okay, children? Once upon a time, there lived a king called Midas. He had a little daughter whose name was Marigold. King Midas was very, very rich. It was said that he had more gold than any other king in the world. He sat on the golden throne and wore a golden crown on his head. He had huge rooms full of treasures, gold, bangles, earrings, necklaces, gold coins, sacks full of precious stone like emeralds, rubies and diamonds. Okay, once upon a time there lived a king called Midas. He is King Midas' children and he is her daughter. So Marigold. Okay, she is her daughter Marigold. Okay, once upon a time king called Midas. Okay, he lived king called Midas. What is the name of the king? Midas. He had a little daughter. So the king had a little daughter. This king had a little daughter whose name was Marigold. Okay, King Midas was very, very rich. This Midas, no, he was very, very rich. It was said that he had more gold than any other king. So what is the, he is having gold than any other king in this world. In the world, he is the richest person in the world. He sat on a golden throne. So this king sat on a golden throne. Throne is nothing but a chair where the king sits. And wore a golden crown. Can you see? The king is wearing a golden crown on his head. He had a huge rooms full of treasures. So this king had a huge rooms full of treasures, like he was having golden bangles, gold bangles, earrings, necklace, gold coins, sack full of precious stones like emeralds. He was having the stones like emeralds, rubies and diamonds. Okay. Even though he was very rich, Midas thought that his greatest happiness was provided by gold. His greediness was such that he used to spend his days counting by golden coins. Occasionally he used to cover his body with gold objects as if he wanted to bath in them. So even though he was very rich, no, the king Midas thought that his greatest happiness was provided by gold. His happiness is by gold. His greediness, what is the meaning of greediness, children? Wanting something more and more. Even he want something more and more. So his greediness was such that, what was his greediness? Such that he used to spend his days. So how he used to spend his days? By counting his golden coins. So he was spending his days by counting his golden coins. Occasionally he used to cover his body with gold objects. So usually he used to cover his body with gold object and he wanted to bath in them. He wanted to take bath in them. One day King Midas was granted a boon by a god. So one day what happened? King Midas was granted a boon by a god. So what is the meaning of boon, children? Everything to be thankful for. So God appeared, tell me your dearest wish and I will grant it. So as soon as the God appeared, so what God is asking, tell me your dearest wish. What is your wish? I am going to grant it. Who is saying? God is saying to this King Midas. Okay. Now, turn the page. Go to the next page. Midas thought for a while. So, when the God said, no, tell me whatever your wish, so I am going to grant it. So he was thinking for a while. Who this? King Midas. He was thinking for a while. Okay. Midas thought for a while and then he said,
I hope that everything I touch becomes gold. So what is asking to a god? So Midas is asking to a god. So he was thinking for a while when God asked, what is your wish? I'm going to grant it. No, the Midas was thinking for a while. And then he said, I hope that everything I touch becomes gold. So what is saying? King Midas is saying to a god, so whatever I touch, everything should become a gold. Okay. Think carefully what you are asking for. So God is saying, think carefully by this what you are asking for. The wise God warned. So the God also warned him, think for a while. But Midas would not stop to think. He wanted to be the richest man in the world. This King Midas wanted to be a richest man in the world. So the God could do nothing else. So he wants to fulfill his wish. No, so the God could not do nothing else. He was not able to do nothing else. And promised the king. So the God promised the king that from the following day, everything he touched would turn into a gold. So now you go and sleep, as I told you earlier in the story. No, so now from the next day, so whatever you touch, so everything will turn into a gold. Okay. The next day, Midas woke up eager to see if his wish would become true. So the next day he was very eager. So eager means what, my children? Eager means keen. He was very keen whether his wish will be what? Whether it will be true or what. So he was very eager. The next day Midas woke up. He woke up eager to see his wish would become true. Whether his wish will become true. He extended his arm touching a small table. So as soon as he wake up, no, just he extended his hand like this, his arm touching a small table. He started to touching a small table, then immediately turned into a gold. So as soon as he touched the table, what will happen, children? Immediately it will turn into a gold. Midas jumped with happiness. So his wish became a true. No, so he's very, very happy. Who this King Midas? So Midas jumped with happiness. He then touched a chair, the carpet, the door, his bathtub, a table, and so he kept on running in his madness all over his palace until he got exhausted and happy at the same time. So what will happen? First he touched the table. So what, the table will turn into a gold. Then he started touching a chair, carpet, door, bathtub, table. So he kept on running. So he was running like a mad all over in his palace. Until he got exhausted. What is the meaning of exhausted, children? Tired. Until he get tired, he is running like a mad in his palace and happy at the same time. And he is very happy at the same time. Okay. He sat at the table to have breakfast and took a rose between his hand. So what happened? He was running like a mad in his palace, no, children? So he was tired. So he sat at the table. So this Midas sat near the table. Can you see? This is the table, dining table. Yes. So he sat at the table to have breakfast and took a rose between his hands to smell its fragrance too. So he sat near this dining table to have breakfast. In between, while having the breakfast, no, he took a rose between his hands to smell its fragrance. If you smell the flower, no, you can smell the fragrance of flower. No, children, to smell the fragrance of flower, he took a rose between. When he touched the rose, what will happen? Became gold. The rose turned into a gold. I will have to observe the fragrance without touching the roses. How? I will have to observe. So the fragrance without touching the rose. So I will have the fragrance without touching a rose. Now go to the next page. Suppose he thought in disappointment. So a little bit he was disappointment. By now Midas was feeling thirsty and hungry. Okay. By now Midas was feeling thirsty and hungry. He was thrilled when the plate, the glass, the knife and fork he touched turned into a gold. Okay. So he was hungry. No. So what he went? He was thrilled. And when he went near the dining table, when he when he touches the plate, glass, the knife and fork, he touch everything will turn into a gold. But has his tongue tasted water, it turned into a gold. So what happened into a gold? But as his tongue tasted water, so even that turned into a gold. He almost choked. He then put some food into his mouth. That too turned into a gold. So what happened? He's feeling hungry. No, he put some food into his mouth. Even that food also turned into a gold. He spat it out. He picked up a peach and bit into it. Ouch, that I got hurt. Ouch, that hurt. He almost broke his tooth. So when he went to have his food, no, so he almost broke his tooth. The peach was hard as stone. The peach was hard as stone. The peach was very, very hard. Like stone will be very, very hard, no children? Like that. Can you guess why? Can you guess why? Just then his sweet 6-year-old daughter came running into the room. So when he was getting hurt, no. So what happened in the meanwhile? Just his sweet daughter. What is her daughter name, children? Marigold. 6-year-old. How old is she? She is 6-year-old. She came running into the room. So she came running into the room. Daddy, daddy. She cried and started to skip towards him. Okay, the king was horrified. So as soon as she see daddy, daddy, she's calling daddy, daddy. She cried and started to skip towards him. She started to coming towards him. The king was horrified. The king was horrified. What is the meaning of horrified, children? Frightened. So he was little bit worried about his daughter. No, no, don't come near me. So the king is saying, no, no, don't come near me. He cried out and ran out of the room. So no, no, don't come near to me. He cried. So he started crying and he ran out from his room. So he ran out of the room. Thinking her father was playing with her. So this Marigold is thinking, oh, my father is playing with me. Even she ran after him and threw herself at him. So she's running and she ran after him and threw herself at him, laughing. The father had to catch her. So she was about to fall. No? So what happened? The father has to catch her and hold of her. But as he touched her, she turned into a golden statue. What will happen? She thought that father is also playing with me. Let me go and jump on him. So he thought that the father thought that she may fall. So he touched her. So he started holding her. So as soon as the king touched her, the marigold turned into a golden statue. You can see here, children. Can you see here? As soon as he touched her daughter, the marigold turned into a golden statue. Okay? Yes. Alas, what a fool. I have been asking for the golden touch. Oh God, please take back your gift, he said and began to cry looking at his little marigold. So what a fool I am now, king is thinking, what a fool. I have been in asking for a golden touch. So as for the golden touch, oh God, please take back your gift. So he is asking to a God, please take back your gift. He said and began to cry looking. So he started crying looking at his little marigold. The guard laughed. So the guard laughed, but he felt sorry for the king Midas, as the king had learned his lesson. So the guard is laughing, but he felt sorry for King Midas. So he's saying sorry for King Midas, as the king had learned his lesson. Now the king has learned his lesson, never to be greedy. So what he has learned, children, he never to be greedy, he said to him. Now go and wash in the river and you will be free from the golden touch. So what the God is saying, no? Now you go and wash in the river, you go and wash in the river and you will be free from the golden touch. Now if you go and wash in the river, so you will be free from the golden touch. Everything that had changed to gold took its natural form once again. So as soon as he came back from the river, so everything will turn into a normal position. So everything that turned changed to gold took its natural form once again. The first thing that King Midas did after coming out of the river was to run to his precious little daughter. So as soon as he came out from the river, so the first thing what he did, he went to her little precious little daughter. Then she was jumping about as if nothing had. So she was not knowing. She was jumping like anything, like nothing has happened. How relieved he was. So now he is relieved he was. He held her close to him and thanked the God. So he thanked to the God who King Midas. Both father and daughter had breakfast. So he started both then daughter and father had breakfast. How soft and fresh the bread roll was. So now he is touching. Now he is touching the bread. So how it is? It is very soft and it is very fresh. How green the peas and how juicy the carrots. Even the how green the peas, the how juicy the carrots. The plain and cool water he drank. So he started drinking the water. Quenched his thirst. So he quenched his thirst and he thanked God for the simple things of life. So now he is very very happy and he thanked the God for his simple things of life. King Midas was no longer the richest king in the world, but surely was the happiest. So now King Midas was no longer the richest king in the world, but surely he was very happy. So what did you learn from this lesson, children? You should not be greedy. You can see here that when the king want to smell the fragrance of the flower, when he touched the flower, even the flower also turned into a gold. Can you see here? Even the flower also turned into a gold. So I hope you all enjoyed this story. Okay, I want you to read the lesson, read the meanings. Okay, children, in case if you have any doubt, you can ask me in the interactive session. Okay, children, thank you.